We all imagine Tyrannosaurus Rex and its closest relatives as giant theropods with huge teeth. And the babies of these dinosaurs are usually depicted as a smaller copy of their parents. And if the general public has at least some idea about the diet of adult tyrannosaurids, the feeding method of young animals remains a mystery even to scientists. But science does not stand still. Not long ago, the results of a study of the remains of a young Gorgosaurus found in Canada 14 years ago were published. They allowed scientists to draw certain conclusions about the process of development of the most dangerous predators of the era of the dinosaurs. Subscribe to our channel, then you'll be the first to know when new videos about the life of the age of dinosaurs will be published. Also from our issues, you can learn many interesting details about the development of life on Earth in general. And thanks to your likes and comments, more and more viewers are watching our videos. Tyrannosaurids include a large number of species that lived in Eurasia and North America at the end of the Cretaceous period. It is believed that they crossed to the American continent via a land bridge across the Bering Strait. This is evidenced by fossil finds in what is now Japan. These were large theropods with powerful hind limbs and practically vestigial forelimbs. Their main weapons were huge jaws, supported by strong muscles and a short neck. The largest of them is considered to be the species that gave its name to the entire family. Scientists estimate that an adult Tyrannosaurus could weigh up to 18 tons, but earlier representatives of the family were less massive. Scientists cannot fully determine the feeding method of the largest predator in the history of the planet. Most studies suggest that Tyrannosaurs were active hunters. Most likely, they used ambush tactics. They made a rapid dash from cover, grabbing the victim with their teeth or ramming it. The impact of such a massive carcass could not only knock one down, but also cause serious damage, even breaking limbs. Thanks to its enormous bite force and the strong, short neck, the T-Rex could lift its captured prey and shake it. Very few animals from the age of the dinosaurs could resist this killing machine. But this image of the T-Rex among the general public is largely formed by various artistic and documentary works. In fact, as seen in films like Jurassic Park, the Tyrannosaurus Rex is an advanced adult. Scientists find bite marks from large theropods on the remains of a wide variety of herbivorous dinosaurs. Quite often, such markings are found on the back parts of the skeletons of various ceratopsians. There is also evidence of tyrannosaurids attacking each other. This may indicate either a fight for females, territory or prey, or cannibalism. The fact that tyrannosaurs and their closest relatives did not disdain to eat their relatives is evidenced by bite marks on the limbs. Such injuries are not typical for dinosaurs fighting among themselves. Several scientifically proven facts support the idea that tyrannosaurs were active predators. Tyrannosaurids had binocular vision. The eye sockets on the discovered turtles are located in such a way that they allow the animal to look forward. This also makes it possible to better estimate the distance to various objects. This skill is undoubtedly important for predators, but among herbivores, there are many examples of a similar arrangement of eyes. At the same time, there is a well-founded opinion that the Tyrannosaurus' vision was quite good. Some researchers claim that he could see no worse than modern birds of prey. We have already mentioned that Tyrannosaurus bite marks on the remains of various large herbivores are quite common. There are finds of Triceratops skeletons with damaged collars, and many herbivores had quite powerful armor on their neck and back. This suggests that protection from attacks on these areas was a necessity. These dinosaurs regularly encountered large predators attacking them from above or from behind. Another argument of supporters of the theory that tyrannosaurs obtained their food by hunting is the structure of their teeth. The sharp, curved back teeth, up to 30 centimeters long, had serrated edges. They were ideally suited for capturing prey and inflicting painful wounds. Large jaws and powerful chewing muscles provided a bite force comparable to that of modern crocodiles. Scientists are still arguing about the maximum running speed of tyrannosaurs. Some say that with such a mass, they could not run fast. Others believe that the structure of its legs allowed him to develop good speed. It is unlikely that a T-Rex could chase a car for a long time, as shown in some feature films, but it would be very difficult for a person to escape from him. And the dinosaurs that tyrannosaurids could hunt were apparently not excellent runners either. Proponents of the theory that tyrannosaurs moved rather slowly believe that the basis of the diet of these animals was carrion. Also, given their size and weapons, they could take prey from more successful hunters. Also, a good sense of smell of the T-Rex and its relatives can speak in favor of eating the carcasses of dead animals. Most researchers agree that tyrannosaurids mainly obtained their food by hunting. But at the same time, they did not disdain either dead animals or their relatives. But all these arguments are valid only for adults. And they became like this only in the last 10 to 15 years of their lives. Young tyrannosaurids were not as large and deadly. Scientists find fragments of their skeletons much less often. After all, the smaller the object, the faster they collapse over time. Therefore, scientists do not know very much about the habits and feeding habits of young representatives of this family. The discovery that we talked about at the beginning of this issue has become very important for the entire paleontology. Scientists examined the remains of a young Gorgosaurus that died at the age of 5 to 7 years, approximately 75 to 77 million years ago. It was no longer quite a cub, but not yet a teenager. The maturation of a Gorgosaurus began between 10 and 14 years and lasted, according to various estimates, up to 6 years. During these years, they grew as quickly as possible, gaining from 600 to 1,000 kilograms of weight annually. These tyrannosaurids lived in Canada towards the end of the Cretaceous period. They were the closest relatives of Albertosaurus, smaller representatives of the family. Their body length reached 9 meters and height at 3 meters. The maximum weight of an adult Gorgosaurus did not exceed 2.5 tons. The found specimen was about 4 meters long and weighed a little more than 300 kilograms. Scientists have discovered skeletons of young representatives of this species before. Researchers were very surprised by the striking difference between adolescents and adult animals. It was also not entirely clear how such a rapid weight gain and transformation into adult predator occurred. One of the most likely explanations for this phenomenon was a change in diet, but scientists have not yet had material evidence of this theory. Young representatives of the largest predators simply had to occupy a different ecological niche. An adult T-Rex, like any dominant predator, had to feed in a certain territory and would hardly tolerate competitors. If the young animals ate the same herbivores, then their older comrades or relatives would simply destroy or drive them out of their land. Quite a lot is known about the diet of an adult tyrannosaurid. Judging by the marks on the bones and the analysis of the remaining coprolites, they feed on the largest herbivores. Such prey was simply too tough for individuals in the literal sense of the word. Their teeth had a slightly different structure, and their jaws were not so massive. They also had different body proportions and were slightly different anatomically from adults. In the process of cleaning the fossilized remains of a young Gorgosaurus, it turned out, at the time of death, undigested bones of another species remained in its stomach. About a week before its death, this dinosaur ate a very heavy meal. His prey was two small dinosaurs related to oviraptors. They, too, were not fully adult individuals and did not exceed the size of a modern turkey. It is believed that they were no more than 1 year old at the time of death. It is noteworthy that Gorgosaurus only ate the lower limbs of both of its victims. That is, he had the opportunity to choose the most fleshy and tasty parts of the body. It is also interesting that even though most of the bones were missing, these partially digested remains were important for the study of this species of oviraptor. Oddly enough, they are the best preserved fossils associated with these dinosaurs. When it became clear that there was something else under the ribs of the Gorgosaurus, scientists began to clean the fossilized bones from the rock from the backside. This was done so as to not damage the contents of the young predator's stomach. As a result, it was possible to preserve not only the skeleton of the Gorgosaurus, but also the remains of its meal. This find confirmed scientists' assumptions about the differences in the diet of young and adult tyrannosaurs. Cubs and teenagers ate smaller dinosaurs and the young of other species. They had to earn their own food. This discovery shed light not only on the feeding habits of large theropods. Scientists have also become more clear about the characteristics of parental behavior and relationships between dinosaurs of different ages. It is unlikely that mom and dad tyrannosaurs caught small dinosaurs for their children or shared the prey with them. They themselves had to make considerable efforts to provide for the needs of their huge organisms. Thank you for watching the next episode on the Age of the Dinosaurs channel to the very end. You can learn more about the development of various types of dinosaurs and other prehistoric animals from our previous videos. They also talk about the origin of life on our planet and the problems of modern society.